mentions ويؤثرون على أنفسهم ولو كان بهم خصاصة, that they give preference to their Muhajir brothers. I begin in the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful. I send salutations on that individual that taught us the true meaning of generosity. I send salutations, peace, and blessings upon that individual that taught us the true meaning of hospitality, the true meaning of being charitable, the true meaning of assisting and benefiting others. And that was the best man to walk the face of this earth, none other than Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Going back 1400 years, in Mecca, the Muslims were being persecuted. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was going through a testing time, a time of trials and tribulations, a time where the Muslims of Mecca, they could not act upon the commandments of Islam openly. It was very hard. They were made to migrate to Medina. And migrating from one region to another is not a minor matter. It's something full of hardship. It's something full of difficulties. Now, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, along with the companions, they migrated to Medina. Because they migrated, they were known as the Muhajirun. The Muslims and the companions in Medina, that were already in Medina, they were known as the Ansar, the helpers. Why? Because they helped those that migrated from Mecca to Medina. They weren't just helpers, they were benefiters, they were assisters, and they knew the true meaning of helping. They never just helped the Sahaba, the migrators, the Muhajirun, they helped the cause of Islam. Now, if we look into the annals of history, then you will not find any examples of how the Ansar, the helpers, helped the Muhajirun. The example of their assisting the Muhajirun is unparalleled, it's matchless, it's incomparable, it's second to none. How did they help the Muhajirun? When the Muhajirun, when they came to Medina, they came with practically nothing. No wealth, no house, nothing to live with, no provisions, etc. So the Ansar, they opened their hands out wide, and not just did they assist verbally by saying welcome, but they were giving their lands away, they were giving their houses away, they were ready to even divorce their wives. If the companions, if the Ansar had two wives, for example, they were ready to divorce one wife and give it to a Muhajir brother, a brother that migrated from Mecca to Medina. A story comes to mind specifically with regards to this case, Abdul Rahman ibn Auf radiallahu anhu, a great companion, a companion that was from amongst those that has been given the glad tidings of paradise in this world from amongst the 10 blessed companions. He was from Mecca, he migrated to Medina. His host was Sa'd ibn Rabi'. Sa'd ibn Rabi' said to Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, "O Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, I have this house, I have this wealth, I'm splitting it into two, I'm making two shares, one for you and one for myself." Not just this, he went to the extent to say that I have two wives. Choose from amongst these two wives, whichever wife you want. Whichever wife you want, I will divorce her. And then after she has gone through a iddah, after she has gone through the time period where a divorced wife or divorced lady goes through after getting divorced, after that you can marry her. So he never said, you know, I'll divorce one, but he gave him the choice to choose between the two. So this is a great sacrifice. This is something that is incomparable. So the sacrifice of the Ansar, how helpful they were, how assisting they were, how charitable they were, etc. It's, you know, incomparable, and we do not find any examples in the annals of history. Now, this is exactly why the Ansar were praised by Allah the Almighty. Allah the Almighty gave them the glad tidings of paradise in the Quran to such an extent that when Allah the Almighty praised them, he mentions, وَالَّذِينَ تَبَوَّأُوا الدَّارَ وَالْإِيمَانَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ, that those, and Allah is referring to the Ansar, when they were in Medina and they brought faith before others. So Allah is saying they were believers and they were in Medina. Allah further on mentions regarding them, يُحِبُّونَ مَنْ هَاجَرَ إِلَيْهِمْ, that they loved the Muhajirun, those that migrated from Makkah to Medina. They loved that they were migrating. In this day and age, if we were to take an example, we've got a house, we've got wealth, we've got everything. If we were to find out someone's migrating and they are going to be coming with nothing, then it's going to be like a burden upon us. We're going to be thinking that, you know what, I'm going to have to share some of my food, some of my house, some of my living space, etc. with him. But Allah is praising the Ansar, saying that they looked at the Muhajir coming there. And then Allah further on mentions, وَلَا يَجِدُونَ فِي صُدُورِهِمْ حَاجَةً مِمَّا أُوتُوا, that the Ansar, the helpers, they never found in their hearts, in their chest, from whatever they were given, any want. So for example, I have got 5,000, 10,000 pounds lying in my bank account. It's just lying there, I don't need it right now. Now, another person migrating to England, for example, an asylum seeker or an immigrant, and I could give that 5,000, 10,000 pounds to him. But I don't need it at the moment. But I think to myself that, you know what, I may need it tomorrow, so you know what, I won't give it to him right now. But the Ansar, Allah is praising them, saying that they were like this. Even though they were blessed with wealth, they were blessed with lands, etc. But that want and that need and that greed wasn't there. They wanted to give everything they could to the Muhajirun. Then Allah further on mentions, وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصًا, that they give preference to their Muhajir brothers. Those that migrated, they give preference above themselves, even though they were in a state of privation. Even though they were in a state of privation. So privation is when a person, he is in lack of essentials of life, like food, etc. But still, the Ansar, even though they may not have had anything, they would still be ready to give it to the Muhajir. So in this day and age, an example is, we've got a plate of food, and we've only got half a plate of food. Now, we know that still less, we would like one plate of food. But then another person comes, and we think, you know what, he's got nothing. So say an asylum brother or sister comes, an asylum seeker or a migrant brother or sister comes, and we know that we could give even a quarter of that food to them. This was the quality of the Ansar. They were ready to even give a bit, even though they had a bit. So Allah is praising them. And then Allah finally mentions, وَمَنْ يُوقَ شُحَى نَفْسِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ, that whoever is protected from stinginess, whoever is protected from miserliness, then indeed these are the people that are from those that are successful. And Allah is indicating to the Ansar that they had no level of stinginess or miserliness in them. They were far away from this. And Allah is saying that they were successful. And remember, you know, stinginess, miserliness, it's a bad trait, something that we should be well away from. We should be embodiments of generosity, like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And from this, we could see that, you know, the Ansar, they left many lessons. And this episode of migration, it leaves many lessons for us. That in this day and age, how can we put it into this context, and how can we fit it in with our people? So for example, we are as Muslims are in England, and we have the asylum-seeking brothers and sisters, the migrants. We need to help them. If we want to be like the Ansar, we need to help those. We can't actually reach the level of the Ansar because they were the companions, they were the best of people after the prophets. But we can aspire to be like them and inshallah reap the same rewards. And I would just like to conclude with a narration of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who time and time again through his prophetic narrations, he echoed these very same sentiments that the Ansar left for us. And that was to help others. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentions, لَا يُؤْمِنُ أَحَدُكُمْ حَتَّى يُحِبَّ لِأَخِيهِ وَلَا يُحِبَّ لِنَفْسِهِ, that none of you can be a complete believer until you look for your brother and sister what you look for yourself. So we like shelter when we're sleeping. We like a roof on our heads. So we should want and like the same for our migrating brothers and sisters, to our asylum seeking brothers and sisters. So I pray Allah the Almighty give us all the ability to understand the lessons of the episode from the migration, and more specifically from the Ansar. I pray Allah the Almighty give us the ability to aspire to become like the Ansar. And I pray Allah the Almighty give us the ability to act upon everything that's been said. Ameen wa akhla da'wana and
كن سعيدا كن فريدا عش بفخر في الحياة.